Palaie Gaoteote, Gaoteote, Palaie Gaoteote, Gaoteote, Palaie Gaoteote. Something like that. When you're 250 pounds, 6'2", move like that, the G is silent. You pronounce it however you want. Welcome back to the Scarlet N Great podcast, everybody, on audio. For those of you watching on YouTube, Ohio State Football with Scarlet N Great, I am Johnny Bullitt. The one you have heard Corey talking about, if you are new to the channel, if you are not new and you've been waiting my return, thank you so much. It's been a long ride getting to this moment right here, but we're here. We're going to pump out some videos. Corey and I will be back. Corey and Shane and myself, we'll mix it all in together. But today we are going to talk about Palaie Gaoteote, Gaoteote, excuse me. A huge get for Ohio State, a transfer linebacker from USC, an absolutely huge boom. One of my favorite things is landing somebody huge in the transfer portal. For those of you who are new to the channel, please like, subscribe, comment below what you think this means for the Ohio State football team. I would love to hear your thoughts on this. Do you think it's as big as I do? Because I really think it's a game changer on this defense. I think it was a huge need. And I love it for so many reasons. Let's talk real quick about who this guy is. A number one, former number one inside middle linebacker in the entire nation, right? 2018 number one inside middle linebacker, according to 247 Sports, number 15 overall recruit. That in and of itself usually says you're dealing with a lot of talent. It's been a long time since we had a linebacker recruit that highly touted. So that is huge in and of itself. This guy, when you look at his stats, you're looking at, I think, 58 tackles in one season. And in 2018, he had 38 tackles in a seven-game season as a freshman. All right. He had 58 tackles in only eight games in 2019. So he's had some injury bug, but he had 7.5 tackles for loss in those 2 years. Not monster stats, but when you look at the reduced games in his youth, those are pretty good stats. And then when you also look at the fact that he's 6'1", 6'2", 250 pounds, a big, thick linebacker, and he moves pretty good, really good for his size, then you're looking at a nice, nice addition, okay? Now, first of all, I just want to give a shout out to Ryan Day and Al Washington for what they continue to do at Ohio State. These guys took a program. It's not like what Urban did, where they took a program, had to rebuild and everything. But the question was, can they recruit at his level? And time again, Ryan Day just keeps answering the bell. And there's this wrinkle in recruiting now with the transfer portal that Ryan Day just continues to knock out of the park. All right. So you get Justin Fields, generational talent, one of the greatest recruit ranking type quarterbacks of all time. Pull him in. Look what he did at Ohio State. Trey Sermon, a position of need. When he fully developed in the Ohio State offense and got right, he set a single game rushing record. Now you add Ote, as we'll call him, in here. And then this is, again, a position of need because they lost out on Henry T, who, you know, transferred from Tennessee, ended up going to Alabama. When you look at that, and when you look at where he fits on this roster, this is just a huge, huge get. I love this particularly. Off the field stuff, I love it because it's got to make Tennessee fans cringe. The Tennessee Volunteers have to just be saying, oh, this could have been my guy. If I'd have just done the bag and the McDonald's bag and the cash right, he could have been our guy. And the former team up north, the former Michigan Wolverine football team fans, as you guys know, there's no team up there anymore. They've been disbanded after a 2-win season last year. Washington used to work for them. They've got to be very sad too. Maybe if we still had Al, we'd still have a football team. But no, he's down here. He's with the Buckeyes. He's doing big things. So I love what Al is doing. He's proven again that the hype is real around his name this offseason, that it was for good reason. All right, let's look at how he fits on the field. This is a guy that I believe will play Mike or Will. I think some give some credit. I think 11 Warriors said the same thing. When you look at his play style, big guy, thicker guy, run stopper, he's not going to be your Sam, your Bullet, your Pete Warner's, you know, Pete Werner, how we were used to seeing him in 2019, roving the overhang type position. You're not going to see that. That's not how I would use this guy. And that's great because Ohio State had a lot of guys that I was like, oh, he seems like a Will, a Craig Young, right? Ronnie Hickman, bullet type. Cody Simon, which I've understood is actually getting some reps trying to play the Will linebacker. But when he came in, I was like, oh, this is maybe a Sam type linebacker. No, he apparently, if I recall correctly, he's getting some reps at the Will position. And then you got, look at Dallas Gant, Taraja Mitchell, who guys you think are Will slash Mike guys. And you think, none of these guys really wow me. Okay. So you take a guy who's a former number one recruit, number one inside linebacker recruit in the country. Okay. This is starting to get me excited. To be honest, not a lot of the names on the roster besides maybe Craig Young, maybe Cody Simon excite me right now in the linebacking room. And they're really young, so I'm still not that excited. But this guy kind of changes things for me. And again, I think that he will rep at Will and Mike, and I think that's huge. What I would like from you guys, I would like you to comment below, and I'll put it on the screen, who you think the three starting linebackers at Ohio State will be in 2021 season. I'm going to go with Cody Simon at the Will. I'm going to go with Ote at the Mike. And I am going to go with Craig Young and Ronnie Hickman as that bullet position rotational, depending on down and distance. All right. So my three, Simon, Ote, Young slash Hickman in that Sam position. You guys may disagree. And you also may say, where does this land Mitchell and Gant? Now, regardless of where these three fit, this offers depth, quite a bit of depth that we need because Ohio State, in the words of LeBron James, lost not one, not two, not three, four linebackers. Losing four linebackers is massive, right? You lost the three starters and your fourth guy, Justin Hilliard, who rotated in and played really, really well. They're all gone. So you got, when you're having to replace four, now you want that depth. So now the fourth man, in my opinion, will be either Mitchell or Gant, or I guess it could be Simon because of his youth. But now you have a better stable of guys, right? And that is going to be good if we ever go 4-4 again. Hopefully we don't do it against Heisman Trophy winning wide receiver. But if we ever go 4-4 again, you play a team like Wisconsin who's trying to pound it down your throat, where you just need to rotate somebody for injury just to give somebody a breather, that type of thing. This offers much needed depth at that Mike slash Will position that I believe was so desperately needed. So is he a starter? I think absolutely yes. I don't think there is any way he is not going to be on the field starting for Ohio State. You may disagree. When you look at play type, someone told me they think he looks like a bigger or a quicker decision-making, knows where to be, Taraja Mitchell. I'm going to go a step further. I think that's a fair comparison. I'm going to go a step further. I think he's just flat out more explosive than Mitchell, but thick and hits hard like that. So I will go, call me crazy, I see him as a mix of Mitchell and Baron Browning. Now, not nearly as explosive. He's not crazy athletic like Browning, but he's pretty athletic. He reminds me of Browning because at USC, when they put him on the edge, he would come off the edge and hit somebody in the backfield. It reminded me of when Browning lined up on the edge and sprinted into the backfield. When you see a 250-pounder burst and move like that, it has a certain look to it. And that's what it just reminded me, that look. Oh, that's the Baron Browning type look. Now, when he's sprinting across the field running somebody down, I'm sure Browning's going to look way more impressive, right? But it had that feel to it. And he's probably a little thicker than Browning, but a little shorter and weight's close to the same. So that's how I see him. So when you mix those two together, and he's been getting lots of reps and minutes for, you know, in and out of injury through his career, I think he's the guy you got to keep on the field. You got to start him. I think he has a fantastic place at Ohio State. Like I said, this defense with the back end being questionable, we don't know how this Barnes, Combs, all this thing is going to fit in, right? But we know now with a much bigger name at middle linebacker that this thing can really start to come together. It had the makings of, let's just face it, it was a bad defense last year. Looked like maybe it could improve to average, but again, your linebacking core is gutted. And now I'm starting to think this could be in a good, like a solid defense. I'm starting to believe that. And this transfer is a huge reason why. Do not sleep on this. I know there's other big things going on in Ohio State recruiting, but I think this is a huge move that inches that defense and maybe even takes a leap closer to the right direction that they need to go. 2 years of eligibility with this guy. I think that you big things in the future for Ohio State and Mr. Ote, as we will call him. I think I got it right at the beginning of the show. I'm not even going to try it again. You know, quit when you're ahead type thing. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining me on this video and this audio clip. We'll make sure this gets uploaded for the audio guys. As always, we wish you goodbye, God bless, and go Bucks.